Okay, good morning everyone. In the last class, we discussed how to find the pattern and give the general term. If you remember, we have seen some in these values in which we tried to find the general formula of that given expression. Now, let's continue our discussion. Question number one of exercise 12.4. So please share the link in NTAB. I will share, don't worry. Now, in 12.4, if you all can see in your book, question number one, it is saying, observe the pattern of digits. Okay? If you observe question number one, there are three patterns. Pattern number A is like this, in which they are trying to make six digitally. You must have seen in digital clocks. Like this they have made. In the second pattern, they have made like this. Like this. And then they're counting this also. They are saying here there are six lines, segments. In this, there are 11 line segments. Then there are 16 line segments and so on. In digital clock, you have seen such kind of structures. Now, if you observe, can you tell me what is the next number in this series? Class 6, 11, 16, 21, what is the next number in the series? Okay, the next one is 26. Good. After that, anyone? Then we have 31. Now we need to understand what is common in all these numbers. We need to find the common thing. Please try to understand and tell me. It is only plus 5. Okay. Okay. 1 and 6 pattern. Okay. Class, if you observe, we can write this 6 as 5 into 1 plus 1. Will that be correct? Let me do like this. One second. We can say this 6 can be written as 5 plus 1. This can be written as 10 plus 1, 15 plus 1, 20 plus 1, 25 plus 1, 30 plus 1. So we have found this pattern in the given numbers. Further, if we want to generalize it, we can say this must have come from 5 into 1 plus 1. This must have come from 5 into 2 plus 1. This must have come from 5 into 3 plus 1. So class, what should be the general formula? If you observe, this 5 and this 1 is constant in all of them. Only thing which is changing is this number, the middle one. So we can say the general formula is 5n plus 1, where n is the natural numbers. Starting from 1, we have the series. Now, what the question is saying is, how many digits are required to form 5 of this kind? Plus, the question is saying, how many segments are required? How many segments required to form 5 of these structure like this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have to find this thing, class. And you have to observe that when one of this kind was required, we multiplied with 1. When 2 was required, we multiplied with 2. Sir, what you have made? Sir, why in 11 it is written 6 digitally? But it is not that, na. They have given you a pattern. It is not from the clock only. I am just taking an example of clock. It is their way of giving the pattern to you. Okay. This pattern they are forming, and they are asking if there are such pattern 5 times, how many line segments are required? The question is, if in this way only we have 5, sir, it is not that it the counting of line segments. How many segments are required to form 5 digits of the kind? Yes, it is that only. Let me tell you what they are saying. We have observed that Ashmit is saying, sir, we can say 6 into 1 minus 1. 6 into 1 minus 1. Okay. But Ashmit, if you go for 6 into 1 minus 1, it will be 5. But you require 6 in the first place, no? I don't think it will work. Please check. Ashmit, it will not work, beta. Please check. Okay, this pattern is correct. 5n plus 1. Now, we can say question is saying to form this single pattern, we require 6 line segments. We require 6 segments. To form 2 such patterns, we require 11 line segments. To form 3 such pattern, we require how much? Yes, but I know it was the Olympiad. How was it, Bani? It is 16. Now the question is asking, how many segments are required to form 5? So there was 1. Here we had 2 patterns. Here we have 3 patterns. Question is asking for 5 patterns. So we have to understand the formula is 5 into 1 plus 1, 5 into 2 plus 1, 5 into 3 plus 1. So for 5, we require, for 5 digits of the kind 6, of the kind, we need 5 into n plus 1, that is 5 into 5 plus 1, 25 plus 1 is 26 segments are required to form this pattern, which is asked in the question. Sir, if pattern would be asking for 8, so 8n plus 1, no, Kritika, you can't say from your side, it depends on the question. Okay. Brain box was logical, rest was easy. Okay, but I did good, beta. Now let's see the second pattern. The second pattern is 4. In the B part, you can observe again, they are forming a pattern of 4 like this. And you can see to form a single 4, they require how many segments? Please tell. To form a single 4 digit, they require how many line segments? They require 4 line segments. Then to form 2 such structures, they are requiring how much? Now they are requiring 7. Then for the 3, like this, they are requiring 10. So we need to understand the pattern first. Although they have given the answer in the book only, but still, if you try to understand, you can find a pattern. You can observe, this is like a table of 3. Class, if you see, the table of 3 is 3, 1's are 3 plus 1, 3, 2's are 6 plus, or you can say 6 plus 1, this is 9 plus 1. So we can say the next will be 12 plus 1. The next will be 15 plus 1 and so on. So now is the time to write the pattern to write the pattern, we have to observe what is changing. This is changing the first place. How? Like this. 3 into 1 plus 1, 3 into 2 plus 1, 3 into 3 plus 1, and so on. That is why we have said the general formula is 3n plus 1. Now, using this general formula, we can tell for any number of digits. Using this general formula, we can directly say the answer. Suppose, again, you want 5 patterns. Again, you want 5 such patterns. Plus, again, we want 5 such. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They are asking how many segments are required. Just put the value in the formula. We will get 3 into 5 plus 1. That is 15 plus 1. Answer is 16. You can count also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So instead of drawing the diagram again and again and then counting, we can go for this thing also. Suppose you want to check for 100. For 100 such pattern, please tell me how many segments are required. If you want to check for 100 such patterns, you need 3 into 100 plus 1, that is 301 line segments. So now you must be thinking, sir, why it is required to study these kind of patterns? So you will realize in the constructions, in many things, when you know about a smaller portion, you can easily find for the larger portion. If there is general formula, you can easily find. Okay, suppose you know how much sugar is required in tea for 5 people. In proportion to that, you can easily find the sugar required for 100 people, the sugar required for 1000 people. So this way it will help you. You must have seen in that videos made on YouTube, when they are sharing a dish with you, they will tell always for two people, you have to take this much spoon of this, this much water, this much this powder. So you can increase the proportion as the number of people. Good, Ashmit. Now, I hope this question is clear to everyone. The C part is also similar, in which they are trying to form digit 8. Okay. Similar is question number 2. If you want, I can take question number C part also. Let me take that also. This formula making or this generalizing is very good concept in life. If you are able to generalize a given pattern, you will always find it easy to find the answer. Okay. Now see, suppose you have this pattern of forming a digit like 8. This is the first one. They have used 7 line segments to form this pattern. Then they have 2 such patterns and they have used 12 for this one. Then they have 3, they have used 17 and so on. Again, we have to observe. Can we use any table? Ashmit, let's see what you are saying. If you are saying 6n plus 1, let's check, Ashmit, whether it is correct or not. Please see. If you go for this formula, what will happen? 6 into 1 plus 1 will give you 7. Very good. It is same. But as soon as you try in this one, it will not work. Class, your homework today will be to complete chapter number 12 in your notebooks. Okay. So I think, Ashmit, now it is clear to you why this formula is not working completely. So before giving the formula, you need to check whether it is working on 3 or 4 values or not. Don't check for 1 value only, check for 3-4 values. Okay. So you can see in this case, 6 to the 12 plus 1 is 13. They are not matching. So this general formula is wrong. That is why we have to change general formula. Daksh is saying 5n plus 2 And Rishi is saying 7 and minus 2. Okay, let us check these also. Not able to erase this. Okay, one second. Let's try. Daksh, one second. Daksh is saying 5n plus 2. And Rishi is saying 7n minus 2. We will check both the formula. Sir, use open board. Bunny, no problem. We will manage. Don't worry. In 5n plus 2, if I put n equal to 1, class, okay, it is in the book only. Then we will check it later on because it is the correct one. Let's check 7n minus 2. Let's check 7n minus 2 given by Rishi and see whether it is correct or not. Everyone, please help. If I put n equal to 1, what will I get? Please tell. If I put n equal to 1, what will I get? If I put n equal to 1, I will get 7 minus 2, that is 5. And I don't think it is correct. We need 7 as the answer. So I think, Rishi, it is clear to you that your general formula is wrong. Rishi, I hope you are able to understand this. Okay. So to form general formula, there are some rules, or you need to observe something. If you see 7 plus 5 is 12, 12 plus 5 is 17. So we are getting an idea that there is a plus 5 difference. Second thing, if we try to see a table, we can see 5 ones are 5 plus 2. 5 twos are 10 plus 2. 5 threes are 15 plus 2. Okay. Daksh is giving a formula 3n plus 4. Class, let's try for Daksh also. Daksh, everyone, please tell, is this formula correct? If I put n equal to 1, what will happen? We will get 3 into 1 plus 4, that is 7, which is correct. If I check for n equal to 2, please tell, will it work? Will it work now? No, it won't work now. So we need to have a formula which will work for every case. That is why your formula is wrong, beta. So the correct formula is 5n plus 2, because we can write 7 as 5 into 1 plus 2, 5 into 2 plus 2, 5 into 3 plus 2, and so on. So this is the general formula for this given pattern. I hope it is clear to everyone. The next question is similar. The next question is similar. Nothing changes there. Question number 2. They are saying, use the given algebraic expression. Yes, Kritika. You can try for different patterns. Maybe you will find some new. Okay. Now, suppose you have the first pattern, or the first expression is 2n minus 1. Now they are asking the terms. If you want to find the first term, simply you have to replace n by, class, please tell. If you want to find the first term, you have to replace n by 1. So it becomes 2 into 1 minus 1. That is 2 minus 1 is 1 only. If you want to find the second term, you need to replace n by, class, if you want to find the second term, you need to replace n by 2. It becomes 2 multiply 2 minus 1. The answer is 2 to the 4 minus 1, 3. Similarly, as the question is asking the 100th term, the question is asking 100th term. Please tell me what is the answer of 100th term for the given expression. What is the 100th term? It is 199. So just put the value 2 into 100 minus 1. That is 200 minus 1. So 199 is the answer. In similar fashion, you can take any expression and find the value. Let me take now the fifth part, because it contains a square. Let me take the fifth part. Sir, this pattern is not written by a formula. Can be solved by solving. Sir, once again. Okay. Kritika, if pattern is not given to you, you can solve for smaller numbers. Suppose next 5 terms, next 10 terms you can find easily. But if the question asks for the 100th term, at that time, it is not advisable. You need to find the general formula for that. Okay? Because finding the 100th term directly won't be easy. Yes. Sir, which term they are asking? That number only we will plus and n. Yes, beta. So if you know the general term, it will be easy for you. Sir, we have to write till 100th term. No, no. Just fill the blanks given to you. Okay? Don't write all the numbers. Just fill the fifth column. The column containing fifth terms, fill that one. The column containing 10th term, fill that one. And last, 100th term. The rest you can leave. Okay? Now, let's take the fifth part. The fifth part is n square plus 1. Again, they are asking fifth term. Before that, let's check. Sir, why you didn't came the last week, Ashmit? Ashmit, you can ask your friends why I didn't came last week. They will help you because they all know now the reason for that. Okay. Now, suppose I want to check the fourth term. Suppose I want to check the fourth term, I have to put n equal to 4. It becomes 4. Yes, class. I think due to some connectivity issue, class got cancelled. One second. Yes. Now, so we were taking this term, fourth one. So the formula is n square plus 1. It becomes 16 plus 1. Answer is 17. So we can say the formula is justified. Now we have to find the 10th term. Everyone? Yes, but due to some problem, it got cancelled. Now tell me, what is the 10th term? For the 10th term, we have to find 10 square plus 1. And we all know 10 square is 100 plus 1, that is 101. Similarly, you can find the 100th term. Everyone, please tell me the answer of 100th term. Again, you have to replace the n by 100 and it becomes 100 square plus 1, that is 10000 plus 1, so 10001. I hope this topic is clear to everyone. And I'm stopping it over here only. One second, stop it.